that many. Mind you, I don't blame them. But nearly finished. I'll just move the little bits that I don't need out of the way. So, to the corners. So that's the way it's going to go when it's folded over. I'll have to straighten the edges up with a knife, obviously. But I've got another four of them to do, so I'll carry on and do another four. I won't put that on the video, I'll just slip off and cut an off cut and make some more of them, and then I'll come back when I've finished. Okay, well, I've been busy and I put a couple of corners in just to prove that I could, so I wouldn't look an idiot while I was trying to explain what I was doing, because I was brand new. And my camera went offline because it was it was run out of steam, so I've charged that up, put an hour in that or so, and what I've got is the one corner's in there. I don't know if you can see, but there is an edge on it there, a slight edge. It runs that way, it runs down towards the centre of the book. I'll show you how I do it in a minute, and the same with the other side. I've done both sides anyway, I'll show you how I do it. So what I do is, I don't want the outside of this because it's pointless, and we know why. Put a bit of glue on the corner. I'm just going to do one at a time. These are a bit different than what you do for the normal so I am learning as I go along. Now put these with a bit of glue onto these on the back. You're supposed to wait 10 minutes and all that, but this isn't real leather. It smells like leather and it looks like leather and it feels like leather, but I'm pretty sure it's not leather. Not the leather that... but it looks good, so I mean, I'm not bothered about that. I mean, it's what I can afford, and you use what you can afford, you play. This is why there is this material, because everybody can't afford the best stuff. And I'd sooner make a mess of the cheaper stuff than the better stuff. And I'm pretty sure they all handle differently. Soaking in well this. Give it a good squashing in. As you can see, I'm using the wrong implement again. I should have been using a bigger brush, shaving type brush, but there you go, that's me. And it will stay wet for quite a while, this. So I'm only going to do one at a time, I'm not going to dash about, I'm not on a conveyor belt. Hold me trusty little piece of card and offer it up. Just over the edge. Making sure you've got enough on that corner. And what I'm going to do is take my paring knife. I did try this with a ruler, but you can't do it as well. There's no way that I could do it. So you take the edge. You can see that there's a sharp edge there, that edge, and then this edge is flat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut away from the corner and give it a bevel. I don't know if I can get down there for you. Yeah. Get it right with it. I've just sharpened this up so it should be pretty good. Just gently go across it. Yeah, just at an angle. Doesn't matter if you cut into the card. Get off. Now what I'm going to do is emphasize that corner. There. This is why I wanted a Teflon folder. It keeps moving the thing around. I wanted something that it grips the leather, these bone folders. That's why I wanted a Teflon one. It doesn't do it with a Teflon one. Okay, turn it over now. Till you a little bit, get rid of these bits. You don't want any of them floating around. Don't want anything that will stick up. I use a book and anything to get your height. And the book over it. Now I'm not an expert at this, so it's not probably not the best way of doing it. The vicar, he's the one that does this well. I'm just learning, so you'll have to forgive me if it's not. Pull back a bit. Just want to get it all in now. And I was a bit short of these corners. I'm using it. He used something similar to this but without a point. This has got a point on, so it's all I've got at the minute. I didn't leave enough material at the ends here, so that's something else I've got. As I say, I'm learning, I'm not... And these you can bang down with a hammer. So it's not perfect, but as I say, I'm learning. It's something you've got to get used to. It's a terrible corner. It's not like what he did. He did some lovely corners. Then again, he's been at it a long time, so I'm sure he'll forgive me if he sees me without laughing. I've got the creases in the wrong places. Never mind, eh? Thank you. Okay, so that's a corner on. And there is a recess in there, you can't see it, but there is a recess. Because what I do when I do the thing is to, that was the wrong measurement I did first of all there, it didn't match up. You've got it, when these things thingy, they must match up with each other like so. They must match up like that on the back and the front. If they don't, it's pointless. So even if you think you've got it right, if it doesn't fit, because they are an art, they're not a science, these. So there you can see I made a thing there. And what I did was, put my ruler on, made a new line. I'm putting my errors in because you're about to make these as well. And I drew a line in the thing, put my bone folder on with a sharp end, and give it a good pressing to get the moulding in there. So I've got a few errors, but they're not they are forgiving, I can get round most of them. And I'm going to put that one on and do the same with that one. So you've seen me do it with that one, so it shouldn't be any bother. And if you want a paring knife, I think they're about £4. There's no handle on it, you can put one on yourself if you want, but sometimes you need to be as flat as you can. So if you're doing paring like this or whatever, you need to be flat, so you don't need a handle on. There's no need for a handle. And yeah, they're about £4, they're quite cheap, they're not expensive. And I've just sharpened this up, and I'm not a grandiose sharpener, I'm not clever at anything, as you've seen. So, what you see is what you get. Anyway, I'll just stop there. Okay, well, just put my bits and pieces away. I should have put them away first. I just thought about it while I was doing it. I should have done it before. I'm not organised at all, really. But I've just finished doing the book bits and pieces. I'll leave my bone folder up, so I'll never find it if I put it away. And a couple of other bits. I'll put my paring knife away. Don't want that, because that's very sharp at the moment. I've just sharpened it up. Anybody that knows how to sharpen would probably laugh at me, but I have sharpened it, and it is it does cut anyway. It does what I want it to do. Anyway, this is the book. And it's up to the present state, and I've done things that I didn't need to do, and I've done some things that I should have done. Things that I've left out I should have done, and things like that. But it's looking a bit messy at the moment, but it will cover up. And it's the Waddle from Twaddle book that I've got. I don't know whether I'll read it or not, this. It's the Phoenicians, origins of the Phoenicians, Britain, Scots and Anglo-Saxons of Britain, and etc, etc. And I've cut it a bit short at the top and the bottom because I wanted a smallish book, but I think I've overdone it. But I've left enough on the edges for to turn the pages and etc, so that your finger marks don't touch the actual text and that. But I've got to put the ends in, and they do say you need a plain end if you're going to put the type of facing that I'm going to do. I'm going to put an English paper on, which is this one. Which I think will look quite nice. But before I do that, I've got to build up this slightly to fit that, because these are raised now. These leather bits are a little bit higher. So even with that on, it would still go underneath it. That might protect it, I don't know, I might not bother. Anyway, so I should imagine that will look quite nice on there. Elegant. Anyway, I've always wanted to do this with this English news wallpaper. We'll call it wallpaper, what is it with me? Anyway, I'll put that on and I'll have to be exact with the measurements for putting that on. But this is hand finished paper. This is, you can see where he's had his finger in the corner there when he lifted it out of the tank. And they're jolly expensive, but I shan't be using a lot of this. It'll just be for special things. They are really for end sheets, the inside of the book, for technical books and things like that. They go on the inside here and there, and then your gold lettering goes on. But as I say, there's no way I'm going to get gold letter on this because it's chrome. It's chrome tanned, and it's got lanolin on, aniline, and or whatever. It's the wrong kind of thing for doing what I need, but it's something I'm just trying. I'm still working in leather, so I'm quite happy at the moment. And I reckon that the hardest thing to do ever is to do well, not so much tooling, because you can do tooling, but this is the wrong leather for tooling anyway. But you can do gold lettering, but it takes a long time to get on well. I have used it and I've put it on, and I've had little victories, but nothing great. Anyway, I'll stop there. So you can see what I'm going to do. And there she is. Well, final stages have pasted the back in, and anyway, I've had it under a bit of presses for a couple of seconds just to make sure that everything goes in well and flattens. I do like a bit of pressure on things, and it seems to work and they don't come undone, so I haven't any problems with it. The only thing I do get is an extrusion of glue comes out if it's excess. I try not to be excessive with glue if I can, because it only needs the right amount. I'm just getting the right amount. So the book is finished, well, as far as that can go, because I don't know any more to do. I've got no idea what else to do to make it any better apart from gold foil or gold tooling, gilding as they call it. And yeah, that's. I always wanted to do a book of this calibre, this type. Always fancied doing one of these. And now I've done one. And the back, I put in with that paper I was telling you about that I bought. £8 a sheet. I'd tell the wife, she'll kill me. But it was the. I've got an indentation around the book. I don't know if you can see that. There is an indentation, and I cut the paper to shape to go inside, and I'm notorious for cutting the right size. So I'd actually use water paste on this, wheat paste, and I left it for a bit to allow it to expand, and it will move into the little corners, because you have imperfections. You never cut square and straight. There's a little bit goes over there. And it does look bad on a well-made book. If you've done something that you're proud of, there should be a thing that goes, a little gap there. But anyway, I can feel the little ridges between the paper. I think they call this the filler. I think this is called the filler. And this is called the nail here. A couple of things I've learnt. I'm not quite sure, but this is called the filler. And this is the three-quarter bind with the edges on in the leather. And the filler, I'll call it the filler has gone up to the edges there and dropped into that recess. So you can feel a little groove. I should have put under paper underneath, but I didn't want to. I wanted it to be protected by the leather so that this paper would be, it won't last as long as the leather, obviously, but I can recover it again. But it's so beautiful. I rather like that. I've fallen in love with that. I think that's rather nice. And yeah, there's a couple of corners there. Yeah. Anyway, it's just about finished now. I'm just waiting for it to dry. I'll put it under the press, and I've got to put the end papers in. And I can't really put in that kind of paper on the inside because I could use the same paper, but it's getting expensive now. So I'll use a bland paper. This is a blue marbled paper, which will set it up quite nicely. So when that goes in, I'll be quite happy. And hope that goes in square. Yeah. And the book opens quite nicely, the hinges are quite good, it lies quite flat, and the hollow back's working very well, so I'm quite happy with it all. There's no problem with it at the moment. All stitched, hand stitched. Yeah. And this is the right type of looking book for this cover, I think. Yeah. So, now I've made it, I'll probably have to read this book now. Twaddle by waddle, yeah. So anyway, that's the finished object. I don't know whether I'm going to make a case, because I'd have to use a lot of this paper to do the outer case, which would, I don't know whether it would spoil the effect, or whether you do it in brown leather on the outside and that on the inside of the case. It would just be a slip case. I wouldn't make a box for this. It's not the kind of thing you'd make a box for. But there's a couple of mistakes on it, which I'll eradicate when it is fully dry. And yeah. So that's the book in all its glory, and I'm very pleased with that. I'm quite pleased with that. It'll probably shrink and do its nut and bits will lift up and everything else, but I'm not bothered because I can re-stick it back in again. I'm not bothered. I've been trying different things. I've been trying wallpaper paste and everything, so just to make sure things work. So I'll put that under a bit of pressure and we'll see. Quite happy with that. I'm quite pleased with that. Quite pleased, yeah. Anyway, I'll stop there.